Thank you, Mr. Chairman. While I respect the gentleman, the maker of the bill, I will have to respectfully disagree, and I say there is no right or wrong time to do right, and that this is the right thing to do, in my opinion. I would also say that growing up as an African-American male in South Philadelphia, if you went back 50, 60 years, when legislation like this came forward and people tried to talk about discrimination against African-Americans, the same argument probably was made, that this is highly too controversial, highly too political of an issue to deal with. So I sit here as an African-American thinking to myself, that the same words that are echoed were the same words that were echoed towards people that look like me, that have my heritage and my lineage. And quite honestly, I won't be a part of sitting on the sideline when we have the opportunity to do it now. Furthermore, I would love to have the policy discussion. I would love to have the policy debate. And I would love for the good chairman to bring up the bill that talks about discrimination against LGBT folks to this committee so we can vote on it, so we can have that debate. Until that time, any opportunity that we have to have the conversation, that we have the opportunity to bar from the discrimination of folks whose lifestyle is not my business or my concern. I mean, quite honestly, it's not the business or concern of my constituents. You know, until that time, I think the least we could do is protect them from discrimination. Not say what they can and can't do as far as their lifestyle. Nobody's having that argument today. The argument that we're trying to have is that folks shouldn't be discriminated against. It's the same argument that folks had with regards to people that look like me. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Too bad you didn't listen to your mother and shame the devil by telling the truth.
Mr. Chairman, Mr. Chairman, don't bring my mother into this.
Reverend Harris, you're the one who brought your mother into
No, Mr. Chairman. I would respectfully ask you not to talk about my mother. That is something I don't play with. And if you want to make a joke, you can make a joke about your mother, but do not make a joke about my mother.
Reverend Harris,
thank you, Mr.
as
Chairman.
I said, the other day you said your mother taught you to shame the devil and tell the truth. It's too bad you didn't do that today.
I did that today, Mr. Chairman. And you're shaming. And you're
Reverend
shaming.
Reverend Harris, you're not recognized right now. You had your chance to speak. Reverend Harris, control yourself, Representative Harris.
Control yourself, Mr. Chairman.
You're out of order.
Mr. Chairman, you're out of order.
Telling the truth would have been discerning between groups of people who have certain characteristics and are born from a certain area or born and due to that, when they were born a certain age, have a certain disability, creating these laws that are going to say that you can't make a judgment on who you're going to hire based on a behavior that they exhibit is not discrimination. It's something that everybody in this room does every day is makes a decision on who you're going to associate with based on behavior. And if we're going to start putting laws in place to say that we can't discern between people based on their behavior, that's when we've gone down the wrong road and we're leaving what's known as discrimination and heading into another area that's quickly been known and most recently been known as political correctness rather than real discrimination.